हेलो एवरीवन, गुड इवनिंग, नमस्ते, जय हिंद। गुड इवनिंग एंड वेलकम टू बायजूस एग्जाम प्रेप। ओके, सो इन क्वांटिटेटिव वेडनेसडे टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अरिथमेटिक क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम आईएफटी एक्चुअल एग्जाम। तो एक्चुअल एग्जाम प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस, राइट? ओके, हेलो एवरीवन। गुड इवनिंग, ओके। सो एजेंडा ऑफ टुडे सेशन इज वी विल डिस्कस अरिथमेटिक क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम प्रीवियस ईयर। सो एक्चुअल प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम आईएफटी एग्जाम। हिमांशु, हेलो। ओके, आ जाएगा लक्ष्य, आ जाएगा। गुड इवनिंग, ओके। तो यस, अरिथमेटिक, राइट, वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ आईएफटी। तो आईएफटी इन जनरल विल गिव यू अ फीलिंग ऑफ लेंथी क्वेश्चन पेपर, राइट, इन जनरल, राइट, बिफोर 2018, ओके। दीज आर मिक्स क्वेश्चंस, राइट, अरिथमेटिक क्वेश्चंस, मिक्स क्वेश्चंस, राइट। आई एम जनरली ओके टेलिंग यू दैट व्हेनेवर यू सी आईएफटी एग्जाम, राइट, इट विल गिव यू दैट फीलिंग ऑफ लेंथी क्वेश्चन पेपर, बट देन योर कट ऑफ्स विल बी वेरी लो, राइट। एट 20% स्कोर यू कैन थिंक ऑफ गेटिंग अ कॉल। Okay, so yes, this is for if I talk about 2021, okay, this January, right, IFT in 2021 it happened, then it was 11 question out of 25 questions of quant, right, of arithmetic were there. Yes, there were easy questions, average questions also. There were 3-4 questions which were a bit difficult, okay, above average. Good evening, Sita. Good evening. Okay, so one of the, right, most important topic, arithmetic. So I'm just discussing mixed questions. So few questions we will discuss from, right, and it will give you that idea that what kind of questions are there in that exam, right, what kind of question, right. Okay, so let's start with this and keep sharing the session. Okay, like or share kar diya karo session ko. Okay, chalo. Let's start with this. Okay, first question. Coming to the first question. Okay, aap try karoge pehle. Dekho, you will see a lot of big stories, right? There may be easy questions also, but that the form, right? First look, right? That will be okay. Not that easy, not that comfortable. Okay, so here the question is, you travel by Delhi Metro every day from Botanical Garden, Noida to Hoge Khas, Delhi. At Hoge Khas Metro Station, you use an escalator. So first line was actually just a story, right? There was no use, right? You know that this first line was just useless in this question, right? Just to increase the length of the story. Okay, but that you will realize later on when once you have gone through that. At Hoge Khas Metro Station, you use an escalator to get out of the station. So this is also a story, right? Okay, nothing much that he is saying. Now, the escalator takes 80 seconds. One day, the escalator was not working. You walk up the escalator. So here, this was logical. Right, the logical. Why logical? Because if it was not moving, you need to walk up, right? That means normally the escalator would have walked up. So escalator, the direction of the escalator is moving up, Because when it was not working, because when it was not working, you walk up the escalator in 50 seconds. Right? So you need to travel for 50 seconds. Okay? Now, how many minutes does it approximately take you to walk down the working escalator? That means escalator is going up, you are walking down. So you need to travel the same distance. Right, but going against the stream, against the direction of the escalator. Right? Okay, can I do it with the help of time and work, simple time and work? That escalator can do it in 80 seconds, right? And you can do it, okay, the person, let's say P, person can do it in 50 seconds. But now what you are doing, the resultant you want, okay, first you just take that like time and work, you take the LCM of this 80 and 50, let's say 400, so 18 to 5, 15 to 8. Now, because you are walking down, that means against the direction, so you want P minus E, that is the work 8 minus 5, 3 unit. So 400 by 3, you need to travel 400 at the speed of 3. So it is nothing but 133.33 seconds, which means 2 minutes, and now the remaining is 13.33 seconds out of 60. So 13 out of 60 is around 0.2. So 2.2 minute will be the approximate answer. Yes, tell me, the question is right. Okay, the story is of escalator, but the question is of time and work, simple time and work, that escalator can do it in 80 minutes, person can do it in 50 minutes, but now they are going against the direction, right? So the work will be P minus E, right? P minus E will become 3 unit per minute, per second, 3 unit per second, and you need to, this the total work is 400 units. So 400 by 3 seconds. That is 133.33 seconds, which is approximately 2.2 minutes. Okay. Right. Here I am just showing you that what kind of arithmetic question they are asking in IFT. Right. There will be long stories. Right. Stories. The first look will not be that comfortable. Otherwise, the question may be very easy. Right. This was very, very easy. Right? If you know what is to be done. Okay. So let's move to the next one. Okay. If you have any doubt, you can ask, or just if you are clear, so then keep sharing the session, share and like the session. Okay. Chalo, next pe aa jao. Koi doubt ho to poocho. Right. The next one is a common question, right? A very, very common question. A group of women in a society decided to execute. Again, the story is different, right? Execute interior and exterior decoration of the society in a week's time. Since 11 women dropped out every day from the second day, the entire decoration was completed on 12th day. How many women participated at the beginning? Okay. So he has given that answer to the nearest integer. Otherwise, number of women, how can it be in fraction? Right? It will definitely be integer only. Right? But the point is nearest integer. Okay? So that means even if it is, let's say 7.1, so you need to take 7, not 8. Otherwise, even if that 7.1 women is there, I will say 8 women. Right? It is more than 7 women, should be 8. But you need to answer in nearest integer. Okay, let's see. Right, now this is just interior exterior decoration, doesn't mean anything. It is they are doing some work. Right, so n women, let's say starting whatever is asked, were there n women. N women can complete it in 7 days, in a week's time it was given. But now what is happening on the first day, n women worked. Next day n minus 11. Next day n minus 22, next day n minus this 33, and so on. 12th day, so see 11 less in the second day, 22 less in the third day, So third day 11 into 2, fourth day 11 into 3. So 12th day 11 into 11, 121. So n minus 121 would be the last term. So here n in 12 terms. So there will be 12n. Here it is 7n. And 11, 22, 121. So, you know, if the, okay, it is negative. Okay, minus. Right, so it should be minus. So it is minus 11 plus 22 plus 33 up to 121 would be first term plus last term by 2 into number of terms. Right? So it is 2 into 133 is 66, 11 into 6 66, 11 into 6 66 and 6 72, right? Which is equal to 5n. So n equal to 726 by 5, 5 into 14, 72, 6, 5 into 5. So nearest integer is 145. So 145 should be the correct answer. Right? Actually, you are getting 145.2. But you need to answer the nearest integer. So 145 should be the correct answer. Okay? Okay, and if you are getting it, like and share the session. If you are not getting it, then ask. Right? Kuch samajh mein nahi aa raha to poocho, agar samajh mein aa raha hai to share kar do, like kar do. Right? So you will find in IFT the stories will be different, right? Okay, they will ask the same thing, right? But they will make a huge story on that. Okay, the long stories. Right, general pattern in IFT arithmetic, long stories. It will be a lengthy looking exam. Okay, and that's why the cutoff is so low. Right, see the next question. Not at all difficult. The next question is not at all difficult and the huge story. Right? Ideally, right, if it is, let's say, if I compare it with CAT, right, in CAT, I would suggest you not to do in the first go. Right? Why? Because even if it is easy, you will read so much and then solve, it will take time. So first do other questions and come back to this question. Right? For a single question. Okay. So here the story is, Joseph is in dilemma. He has been offered a job which would pay him 80,000 per month for the first 3 years, 120,000 per month for the next 3 years, okay, and rupees 1,50,000 per month for the remaining 4 years. So 3, 3, and 4, total 10 years. Okay, he has also been offered an MBA at prestigious place and he is considering whether to accept the job or go for the MBA. The first year tuition fee is this, second year tuition fee is this. After MBA, he will get a salary of 2 lakh per month for the first 4 years, then 250 per month for the remaining. What will be the approximate percentage gain for Joseph in opting for the MBA instead of the job in 10-year horizon? Consider no discounting of money. No discounting of money means, okay, so you will not consider any interest or you will not consider any depreciation, right, of the value. So any no inflation, nothing is there, right? You will just calculate a simple, right, total. Okay, just see what is to be done, right? No discounting of money means, okay, so this question was not, you will not see normally these kind of question in normal books, right? So see what he is spending in case he is going for a job, right? So what he is getting, 80,000, right? I am not writing 1,000. So just forget about 1,000, 80,000 for first 3 years, 12 months each, right? Then 1,20,000, okay, so 120,000 for the next 3 years, 12 months each, monthly it is. So then 150 again for the remaining four year, 12 months each. So the total he is getting, if I take 12 common, 0 common, 1, okay, so this 0 common, right, 12 common, 120 common, that means, right, and 3 also common we can take. Yes, we can take 3 also. So 123, 360 I am taking common. So here it will be 8 only. 123 gone 12 only. So 12 into 30, 360. So here 5 into 4, 20 would be remaining. So this is the total right income for going for a job, right? So this will be the total income. Whereas if we go for MBA, right, what will happen? So he will get a salary of 2 lakh, that is 200,000 for 12 months and 4 years, right? Plus 250,000, 4 years, 12 months, right? And minus, he will spend in the first 2 years, 16 and 20, okay, 160, so 1600,000 and 2000,000. So 3600,000 he will spend, right, in doing MBA. So this is in income in this case, that will be, okay, 48 common into 200 plus 250, 450 minus 3600, right? Which is 450 into 2, 900 into 24. That means you can say 240 into 9, 2160. Okay, wait a minute. It will be 450. So double it, 900, 900 into 24. 900 into 24. That is 21600 minus 3600. So it will be 21 minus 3, 18,000. So here the income will be 18,000. 1000. 3 zeros I have removed. And here the income was 12, 8, 20 and 20, 40. 14 to 36, 14400. So what is the increase? What is the increase? Right? Just take the ratio. Just take the ratio. 36 into 4, 36 into 5, 4 is to 5. That means the change is 1 over 5, 4. 1 increase on 4. So 25% should be, right, the percentage gain over the job. If we go for job, his total income becomes 14400,000, right, total for this 10 year scenario, right? And if we go for MBA and then job, then his total income, right, will become 18,000, right? So the ratio is 4:5. So one more on 4. So gain of 1 on 4, that is 25% more would be the gain if we go for MBA. Okay. So comparing no discounting of money means you need not to consider any interest in all, right? You will not consider any interest. You will not consider any depreciation of the value, anything you will not consider, right? Okay, rather depreciation, not inflation, right? Any inflation factor will not work, right? Any interest will not work. Yes, Lakshya, right? So indirectly, they were making you understand in the entrance exam only. They were telling you that why you should do MBA. Okay, great. Okay, so let's move to the next one. Okay, you can see that the question was not at all difficult, but the only thing is that lengthy statement and you are doing, okay, simple calculation. There is not much logic in this, right? Not a big concept. Okay, very simple percentage change concept. Okay, see the next one. So you keep on seeing the stories. Now these stories you won't find in normal, right, your percentage chapter, profit loss discount, interest. You will find a different kind of story. Here you will find a different kind of story. Okay, see, KBC restaurant. Okay, restaurant chain regularly conducts survey of its customers. The customers are asked to rate the food quality, service and price as excellent, good and fair. Customers are also asked whether they would come back. It was found that 76% customers say they will come back. Among us, those who say that they will come back, 57%. Okay, so this is again a very easy question, right? Out of these 76, right, excellent, good and fair. So excellent They are saying 57%, 57% saying excellent, 36% saying good, and the remaining, right? 57 and 36 would become 93, so 7%, right? 7% saying fair. Okay. Now, of the remaining, of those who say that they will not return, so 24 says not return because 76 says return 24, so total is 100%. Out of these 24, excellent, good, and fair, they are 14%, 32%, and 54%. Now, what he is saying, what approximate percentage of the customer rated the restaurant as good? So he wants weighted average, right? Good here, so total percentage. You can simply calculate 76, 36% of 76 plus 32% of 24, then also you will get an answer, right? That is 36% of 76 plus 32% of 24. You will still get the correct answer, right? Without going for any weighted average or so. So this becomes 36. Okay, if I take common 4 and 4, 4 and 4, let's say 16 by 100, I am taking common. So here 9 into 19, 171, 8 into 6, 48. So this becomes 16 into 17, 4, 21, 219 by 100, right? This is the, so what percentage it would be? 16 into 2, 32, 3200 plus. So 32% plus 35% should be the answer, right? Approximate. You can multiply exactly 16 into 9, 144, 14, 16 and 14, right? 30, 16 to 32 and 3, 35. Exactly, right? 35.04% would be the correct answer. I'm saying 35% approximation. 16 into 200, it would be 3200. So 3200 more than that, what answer you will mark? You cannot mark this answer. You cannot mark this answer. 51% is too much, right? It is not 16 into 200 something will not give you, right? 550, that is 1500, 5000, right? That will not be possible. Simple answer, 35. Okay, right? Okay, keep interacting and keep sharing. Keep okay. Here, arithmetic, I'm just showing you the story, the kind of stories they have given, right, in IFT exam. Okay, and once you face it for the first time, you will find it, oh, this is not a regular story, right? Regularly, you will not see such stories in your books, right? Okay, see this. The simple, okay, question on percentages and see the story. Nawab has two sons, Saif and Amir, who have export businesses. Nawab's satisfaction utility level is given by adding twice of the satisfaction level of Saif with satisfaction level of Amir. So that means Nawab satisfaction level is, let's say, N. Saif satisfaction level is S. So it is twice of satisfaction level of Saif plus Amir A. So this is the satisfaction level of Nawab, right? Now, Saif makes a profit of rupees 100, the satisfaction level goes up by 10%. And if he suffers a loss of 100, his satisfaction level goes down by 10%. If Amir makes a profit of 100, his satisfaction level goes up by 5%. And if he suffers a loss of 100, his satisfaction level goes down by 15%. See the story, right? Currently, Nawab's satisfaction level is 24. Satisfaction level is 24. Nawab's, okay? N is 24 right now, okay? And okay, the satisfaction level of Saif is same as satisfaction level of Amir. If that is same and it is 24, it has to be 8 and 8 because 2s is s and a are equal. So it will become 3s equal to 24. So s will be 8, a will be 8. This is the current level. Because then 8 into 2, 16 plus 8 will be 24, right? Now, if SAF makes a profit of 100, now SAF makes a profit of 100, its satisfaction level goes up by 10%. So it means it will become 8.8. So 2 into 8.8, 10% up, right? And Amir suffered a loss of 100. Loss of 100 means goes down by 15%, right? So 8 goes down by 15%. If 15% of 8 is 15 into 8, 120, 1.2. So it will become 6.8. So now it will become. So what is the change, right? You can say 2 into 0.8 here, 1.6. Here minus 1.2. So that means it will change by. Okay, so 24 total, and it will change by. It is 1.6 and minus 1.2. So plus 0.4. Right? Now the change is 0.4 change on 24, so which is 4 by 240, or you can say 1 by 60. Now 1 by 6 is 16.66, so 1 by 60 will be 1.66. D option would be the correct answer. Okay, just see that if you solve this, you can calculate this 8 into 2, 16, 17.6 plus 6.8, which will become 17.63, 24.4. So it was earlier 24, now it is 24.4. So 0.4 change on 24, which is 1 by 60, and 1 by 60 is 1.66%. Right? You know 1 by 6 is 16.66%. Yes, I'm telling you the questions from previous year. Okay, these are previous year questions of IFT. Okay, but the questions are easy. Questions are not at all difficult. The problem is with the length of the question, right? The stories. And when you are reading the stories for the first time, right? Okay, you may understand the entire stories exactly, or you may have certain doubts. So you may read it again. Right? In questions, when you read the story for the first time, you may have doubts. Okay, the next one. An e-rickshaw owner makes 24 trips a month with 4 passengers per trip. If his interest cost for purchase of e-rickshaw is rupees 120 per month, okay, this is the cost he will need to pay for that purchase of e-rickshaw. Okay, koi EMI ja rahi hai, let's say. He earns 15% of profit a month. Profit is the difference between revenue and cost. Okay. So let's say the cost of running, okay, it is variable and fixed. The fixed cost is 120 for a month. Okay, the first situation is that 120 per month is the fixed cost. Plus, right? Let's say he is carrying. Okay, total cost. Revenue per passenger is same. Total cost to be proportional to the interest cost. Right? Total cost to be proportional to the interest cost. Okay? So it is just total cost is the proportional to the interest cost. And what is asked? What will be the approximate percentage profit? Okay. 15% profit a month. Revenue per passenger is same in both the cases. Now, profit is the distance between the revenue and the cost. So let's say he is making only trips, right? That means what is happening? Okay, so 24 trips is costing him 120 per month. So when he will make 20 trips, his interest cost will become 24 into 5, 20 into 500, because it is proportional. Total cost is proportional to the interest cost. Okay. So let's say now the cost will be 100 per month and he's making a trip. Now, initially he was carrying 24 trips with 4 passenger per trip. That means 96. Let's say the revenue per passenger is X. Okay. So he was getting 96X minus 120. Okay. Here the profit was 15%. Right. If 15% was the profit, there is no other cost involved, na? Right? So can I say direct if the 15% was profit, 15% is profit, that means 120, 15% will be 18 only. Right? So that revenue was 96x was 120 and 18, 138. Okay, so this will be 6 into 16, 6 into 2, 6 into 3, so x is 23 by 16. Okay, let's see. Let's see if we are understanding it properly. Let's see. Now, the next thing is what will be the approximate percentage profit for the same month if the owner undertake 20 trips a month with 5 passenger? So let's say now the passenger are 100, the revenue is 23 by 16, so 100 into x, the revenue per passenger is same, right? Okay, minus. Now the cost is also 100, right? Because he is only making 20 trips, right? And his interest cost is reduced by 10% for the month. Oh, interest cost is reduced by 10%. So if it is reduced, that means the cost will become 90. Right? So that means here the okay cost for your this is your revenue SP by CP if I draw. So it will be 0 cancel. 4 into 4, 4 into okay. 8, 2 into 8 and 2 into 5. So it will become 115 by 72, which I can say the profit would be 28 and 15, 43 on 72. Right? So what will be the approximate percentage profit? 72 into 6. So 66 can be the only answer. It is approximately 2/3. Right? No, it is not 2/3. It is not 2/3. Right? It is less than that. 72 into 6 would be, it is 60% only. So there may be some right problem of understanding, maybe. Right? That language is such, right, that okay, where the problem is? The problem is with this part. Okay, so I can answer this. Maybe this is the correct answer. But the problem is with this part, right? Understanding this total cost to be proportional to the interest cost. Right? So what is the cost factors? If it is the only interest cost of purchaser is 120 per month, okay, for the purchase of e-rickshaw. Right, 120 per month, or for making a trip, there is some extra cost. Okay, so it may be that 120, because this is interest cost, and interest cost is reduced, and revenue. Okay, interest cost, but then how come the total cost to be proportional to the interest cost? Right. Just try to understand this total cost is proportional to the interest cost. Interest is 120. Okay, let's see. Let's try to again understand this. Then 24 trips, okay, maybe 120 is the fixed interest cost plus now 24 trips. Okay, wait a minute. I will just check the language of the question. Wait a minute. Okay, just I'm confirming. Okay, wait a minute, wait. This is question number six. Okay. It was 120. Okay, let's solve it again. Okay, what he want to say is, okay, because the statement was such, right? See, what he is saying is that 120, it is given total cost to be proportional to the interest cost, right? So that means total cost is not 120 but 120 into some constant of proportionality. So 120K is the total cost, right? Now you are having 15% profit also, right? So that means total cost and total selling prices 24 trips of 4 passenger and per passenger cost, let's say X. Okay, so total SP by CP is 15% profit, 115 by 100. Okay, this is one equation. Okay, so you can cancel it, 24 into 5, 5 into 20. So 5 into 4, 5 into 23. So this will become XYK as 23 by 60, right? Which we also calculated the same thing, right? Now the second situation is important. The SP becomes 20 into 5x, 20 trips of 5 passengers, and x is the revenue per passenger. Okay, now cost is 120 reduced by 10%, right, into k. It is proportional to the right interest, which actually doesn't matter here. Okay, and the profit would be here SP by CP I want to calculate. But X by K we already know, right? X by K we already know. So let me put the value of X by K. X by K, so I'm putting the value here 23 by 16, right? So what it will become? 0.9, 0.9 will be 9 by 10. Okay, point I will cancel with this zero. Okay, so this will be 25. Okay, 4 into 5, 4 into 4, right? So it will be 5 into 5, 25 into 23. Numerator is 25 into 23, and denominator is 12 into 9 into 4. Okay, so that means 12 into 36. Okay, this is the 25 into 23 is 575. Okay, and 12 into 36 is 12 into 3, 360 and 72, 432. Right, I think this is what we also got the same thing, 143, right, on 432. Okay, but this is approximately one third. So you are getting revenue 33.33, right? One third revenue. Okay, this is what you have approximate profit percentage for the same month if the trips are this and this. Okay, so X, Y, K. Okay, mathematically I am doing it. Right, so you can see that confusion in the language. Okay, when he asks such questions, which is not a common language, right, then it would be a problem. Okay, so let's move to next one. Now, a motorboat takes the passenger from Rishikesh to Haridwar and back. Both the cities, Rishikesh and Haridwar, are located on the banks of River Ganga. During Kumbh Mela, to earn more money, the owner of the motorboat decided to have more trips from Rishikesh to Haridwar and back. So he increased the speed of the motorboat in still water by 50%. By increasing the speed, he was able to cut down the travel time from Rishikesh to Haridwar and back by 60%. Okay. So initially, the speed of the boat was, okay, let's say, because he is increasing the speed by 50%. So initially, let's say speed was 2x, right? Speed in still water, it was 2x. And now it will become 3x. This is initially, this is now, he is changing, right? Okay, this is speed in still water. But speed of the, okay, the ratio of the speed of motorboat in still water to that of speed of River Ganga. Now, speed of River Ganga is, let's say, Y or R. So, that is R in both the cases, right? Plus R and minus R will depend. It is a downstream, okay? And upstream, it will become 2x minus R and 3x minus R, okay? This will be increasing it by 50%. But if you are doing it, right, what will happen? Okay, first thing is he is going and coming back, going and coming back, right? Going and coming back means average speed is b square minus, okay, you know, average speed of the downstream and upstream. If the same distance is covered in downstream and upstream, when speed of the boat in still water is b, speed of stream is s, it is b square minus s square by b. This is the average speed, right? So here you can say the average speed in this case, average speed in this case will be 2x square minus r square by b, that is 2x. And here it would be 3x square minus r square by 3x. If this is the ratio of the speed, time taken. Now time taken would be inverse. If I say time taken will be inverse. Okay. And here it is cut down the travel time by 60%. That means it becomes 40%. Right? Can I say now 3x square, right? This time, that is 9x square minus r square by 3x divided by 4x square minus r square by 2x. Okay? So here the time taken will be more, here the time taken will be less. So this will be more time. So this will be less time, 40%, 40, 100, 5 by 2. So x will cancel, right? This 2 will go here. And this 3 will come up, 3 by 2, right? So that means 9x square minus r square by 4x square minus r square. Again, this is seemingly mathematical, right? But here you will get xr ratio 4, 9, 36x square and 15, 4, 60. 60x square minus 36x square, it will become 24x square. And here 4r square, 15r square, 15r square minus 4r square, it will be 11r square. Right? So if I do x by r, okay, 4r square and it will be 15. 15 minus 4, it will be 11. Right? Okay. So we want the speed of the motorboat in still water. That is x. No, it is 2x. The boat in still water was 2x. Okay. So that means what we want here is 4x. Right. So if I take 2x square by r square, it will become 4x square by r square. So 4x square by r square will be 11 by 6. Right. So that means 2x by r, that will be 11 by 6 root. So A option should be the correct answer. Okay. Lakshya, yes. The thing is that first you are going with a speed 2x. 2x I have taken because you are increasing the speed by 50%, which is 2 is to 3. This is increase of 50%. Right, A is the correct answer. You need to take 2x by r. Okay, it was 2x square by r square, which is 11 by 6. So 2x by r will be 11 by 6 root, Sita Kumari. Okay, so I have taken 2x and then 3x as the speed of boat in still water. Right, Lakshya. Now, r is the speed of river Ganga. Okay, so it will be plus r or minus r depending upon. Right, a downstream and upstream, but the average speed when the speed of the boat is B, speed of stream is S, river is S, then average speed is B square minus S square by B. So average speed in this case was this, average speed in this case was this. So time taken will be inverse, right? So time taken will be inverse, and he is saying that time taken cut down by 60%, that means it will become 40%, right? So time taken in this case, right, or new case will be this, which is 40%, right? This will be 40% and this will be 100%, right? Time taken will become 40% of the initial. So this becomes mathematical. So you are solving the question like this. Okay. Okay, just use this formula of average speed b square minus s square by b, right, with the original speed 2x plus minus r and 3x plus minus r in the new case when the speed of the motor boat in the still water is increased by 50%. Okay, the time taken now should be the next case. Okay, it should be 40%, 60% cut down, so 40% should be the time taken. Okay, so you are getting x by r. Now the next question, right? Average I think you can do easily. A cricket team has 11 players and each of them has played 20 matches till date. Okay, so this spelling is mistake. Let's say Virat. Okay, this is also Virat. Virat, Rohit, Mahendra, Rahul and Shikhar have scored runs at an average of 60, 55. Rest of the player have scored at an average of 25. Okay, Lakshya, the time taken is inverse. So what I have done, the time taken for the starting over time taken of the new one. So new case, it should be lesser. So 40% should be newer case. The initial time taken should be 100. 100 by 40, that's why I have written, right? Otherwise, you will take time taken, reverse you, right? Right, it will be 40 by 100. Okay, speed ratio, inverse ratio will be time taken. Okay, now in the next 10 matches, Virat and Rohit each scored 900, whereas Mahindra scored twice that of Rahul. After 30 matches, if Virat's new average score is twice that of Rahul, okay? So Virat's 20 matches, it was an average of 60. Next 10 matches, he scored 900, right? That means 20 into 60, 1200 plus 900, 2100, right? By 30, what is the average? 70. 70 is the average. Now, Virat's new average is twice that of Rahul. So Rahul average should be 35. And Rahul's average initially is 45, right? Now the next 10 matches, next 10 matches, we don't know how much Rahul scored, right? 10 into X or whatever he scored. So it is 900 and it is 1050, so it will be 150. So you can say average of the next 10 matches, or in next 10 matches he has scored 150, right? Okay. Now, what is the approximate average score of Mahindra? Now, it is given that Mahindra scored twice that of Rahul, right? Mahindra scored twice that of Rahul. Okay. So Mahindra scored, if Rahul has scored 150, right? So Mahindra has scored 300. And initially Mahindra scored average was 50. So 50 into 20 plus 300. So it becomes 1300 divided by 30. So 0 cancel. So 3 into 4, 12, 10, 3 into 3, 43. So 43 should be the correct answer. This was a very simple question, right? Only thing is, again, that you need to focus what is given, what is required. So Virat's score is given, done, right? Mahindra scored, it is given that Virat and Rohit each scored 900. So Virat, from Virat I got that, here it was given that Virat's new average score is twice that of Rahul. So I got the average score of Rahul, right? From here I got that what is Rahul scored in the last 10 matches. And Mahindra scored twice that of Rahul. So I got Mahindra, how much score Mahindra got in the last 10 matches. And from that, we got the total average score of Mahindra in the 30 matches. Okay, because initially we have given the average. So the Mahindra's was average was 50 for the first 20 matches, that is total 1000 score plus 300 in the last 10 matches. So 1300 divided by 30. Okay, that will be 43 point something. Okay. So this was the last question of the day, right? But again, you will see, right, in IFT the stories, right? Most of the stories you will see that they are lengthy story. 900 each, okay? Each scored 900. Lakshya, Virat and Rohit each scored 900 runs. Right? Okay. So here, now CAT 2021, till the time CAT happens, 7 p.m. daily preparation booster is going on. And then, okay, these are the weekly schedule: strategic Monday on 10 p.m. Monday, Tuesday 9 p.m. DI mantra, quantity Wednesday 9 p.m. Wednesday, grammar 9 p.m. Thursday, Friday logic 9 p.m. and Saturday 9 p.m. reading, Sunday 9 p.m. inquisitive. Okay. And CAT D-Day activity, it will be the first slot complete analysis will be at 1 p.m. Then 5 p.m. slot 2 analysis by G Gautam Baba and Saral sir. And slot 3, I will take the analysis with Pranav at 8 p.m. Okay. Right. You can just attempt this mega mock CAT 2021. Okay. This is going on. Now there are, I think 2 hours left. Okay, till 12 you can attempt this. Yes, there may be, Subhanshu, right? Stay positive. There may be. Okay, so yes, these are the mentors who are guiding you, and keep sharing the session. आएंगे आएंगे बिल्कुल आएंगे शुभांश, राइट? कैट एग्जाम में बिल्कुल वैसे सिमिलर दिखेंगे आपको, राइट? कैट में तो काफी सिमिलर दिखते हैं, राइट? कैट में यू विल नॉट फील लाइक व्हाट हैज हैपेंड टू मी, ओके? नो, देयर विल बी ओके सिमिलर काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन. ओके, सो सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन देन, राइट? एंड यू कैन फॉलो अस ऑन इंस्टाग्राम, फेसबुक, टेलीग्राम, लिंक इज इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन. थैंक यू, बाय बाय, नमस्ते, जय हिंद, गुड नाइट.